Hello everyone, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today in the second chapter, that is primary operation on numbers, we are going to solve next questions. Yesterday we have seen questions up till 14, okay. The 15th one question is for homework. Today we will see the questions from 16th onwards. The question number 16 is, if a 14 times 22 is added to a number, the result is 528. What is that number? So see here, this question. It is like one statement. See, if 14 times 22, we have to understand meaning of each words. 14 times 22, you know, times means what? 14 times, we say 5 times 2, 3 times 3, 3 times 4 means what? 3 multiplied by 4. 3 times 4 means 3 multiplied by 4. 5 times 2 means 5 into 2. 6 times 7 means 6 multiplied by 7. Similarly, 14 times 22 means 14 into 22. Okay? So 14 times 22 is added. Is added means plus. Added to a number. Now see here, this a number means what? A number means which number? Is it given here in this problem? A number? It is not given. So for that, a number means it is unknown number. We don't know that number. Rather, we have to find that number. So that a number we will consider x. Okay, we will consider as a x, any alphabet. Then the result is, result means where we write result after writing equal to sign, right? So the 14 times 22 is added to a number gives or result is 528. This is the statement. We have to convert it into mathematical language or mathematical way. Understood? 14 times 22 means 14 multiplied by 22 is added to a number. A number we don't know, that's why we have considered is it as a x. Then it gives 528. Okay. Now see here. And what is that number? Means we have to find this number. The unknown number which we have considered x, that we have to find. Okay. So how to find that? See, first we will multiply this. For 14 multiplied by 22. 14 twos are 28. 8 will come down, 2 will be carried, and 14 twos are again 28 plus 2, 30. 308. So 14 into 22, their multiplication is 308 plus x is equal to 528. Again, here this is also new process for you, new method for you. See, 300 plus x is equal to 528. See, remember the ninth one problem. Sum of two number is 528. One of the number is 308. What is the another number? Sum of two number. Sum means addition. Addition of two number is 528. One of the number is 308. What is another number? So this number means x. To find this x, what we will do? Here 528 is there, right? And this 308, no. We will bring on the opposite side of equal sign. This side of equal sign. So as here it is positive 308 plus 308, when it will come here, it will become minus 308. This is called transposive rule. I'll explain you. See, this is equal sign. And this side of equal sign, see, this is our left hand, right? So it is called LHS, left hand side. And this side of equal sign, this, that is called RHS, right hand side. Left hand side and right hand side, and middle there is equal sign. What is meaning of this? What is meaning of this equal sign means the value of left hand side and value of right hand side is equal. Now whenever we suppose there is number of plus 5 and here there is 4, okay, means plus 4. whenever we have to change side of that number, plus 5, suppose we want to bring here on this right hand side, at that time it will change its sign. It will come on the right hand side, but it will change its side. That plus 5 will change into minus 5. Minus 5 will change into plus 5. Multiply by 5 will change into divide by 5. And divide by 5 will change into multiply by 5. Multiply, opposite division, plus opposite subtract, minus. Or minus opposite plus, divide opposite multiply. So this way, this is the rule, it is called transposition, rule of transposition or transposive rule, okay. So similarly here this 308, it was on the left hand side and we brought it on the right hand side. So it is plus here, when it came here it became negative, minus 308. And x will put on this side only because we have to find value of x. So x is equal to 528 minus 308. See, 528 minus 308. 8 minus 8, 0. 2 minus 0, 2. And 5 minus 3, 2. 220. So, value of x means the number, that number. So, the number is 220. That means what? 14 times 22, when we will add in 220, we will get 528. Understood? See, next question, question number 18. Which least number be added to the product of 654 and 22 so that the sum would be greater than 20,000? See the question, which least number be added to the product of this? Now product means what? Nothing but multiplication. So in the multiplication of 654 and 22, let's find product. Product of 654 and 22. First we'll find is equal to 654 multiply by 22. Product means nothing but multiplication. So 22 fours are, do you know 22 table? You must know. 22 fours are 688. Okay. 22 fours are 88. So 8 will come down, 8 will be carried. Or if you are not able to multiply this way, we'll multiply 654 into 22, 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 2 sixes are 12 and 1, 11, 13. For these two, put 0 here, then again 2 fours are 8, 10, 1 carry and here 13. Okay, 8, 8, 3, 4, 1, 14,000. 388. Okay. So product of 654 and 22. Product of 654 and 22 is 14,388. Now the question is, in this product, in this 14,388, which smallest number, which least number to be added so that we will get the so that sum would be greater than 20,000. We want sum of these 14,388 plus that least number we have to add in this 14,388. We have to add the least number, smallest number, to get sum more than greater than 20,000. Okay, so that least number we'll consider here x. Least number we'll consider x. So 14,388 plus x is equal to, now more than 20,000 means we can get 20,001 or 20,002 or 20,003 or 20,004, 20,500, 20,000 21,000, 25,000, any more than 20,000 means any, but we want least number to get some more than 20,000. So least means what? We can, if we write this way, 20,001. Okay, this is the 20,001 is also more than 20,000, right? As we have to find least number, so we need to take this sum. We need to take 20,001. Understood this? See, why 20,001 only? Because here we have to add least number, smallest number into 14,388 to get some more than 20,000. Okay, as we want here least number, so we are taking here just one more than 20,000. Otherwise we can take any number more than 20,000, but here we want least number, so we are taking just only one number more than 20,000. So now see, to find this x, again we will use your same rule, transposive rule. 20,001 minus this 14,388 will bring here, and it will become minus 14,388. So see, 20,001 minus 14,388. 1 minus 8, not possible. But see, to take borrow, there is 0, 0, 0. So cut this 1 right here up, right here 11. This 0 will become 9, this 0 will become 9, this 0 will become 9, and this 2 will remain 1. Now 11 minus 8, 3. Correct? 9 minus 8, 1. 9 minus 3, 6. And this 9 minus 4, 5. So we need to add x is equal to 5,613. Understood? So the meaning of this is, we need to add the least number 5,613 in 14,388 to get the answer more than 20,000. Understood? This least number, this smallest number to be added in the 14,388, which is product of 654 and 22. Okay, we can add to get more number more than 20,000. We can add other number also, but this is the least one. This is the smallest. Understood? And that smallest number can be obtained by taking just one number more than 20,000. That is 20,001. Okay. If you take here 20,002. And then we hear the number we will get, it would not be smallest. It will one more than this. Okay. So this is the number which is least that can be added in the 14,388 to get number more than 20,000. Okay. So just pause this video and write in your notebook.
Let's solve the next question. That is question number 19. A school bought 65 benches for rupees 40,950. Find the cost of each bench. So see here, cost of 65 benches is given. Cost of 65 benches is given. What is that? 40,950. And we have to find cost of each bench. Cost of each bench, that means cost of one bench we have to find. So when given for many and asking for one, when this type of condition is there at that time, which operation we do? We go for the division. So here we have to divide total cost of 65 benches by 65. So To find cost of each bench, we will divide rupees 40,950 divided by 65. Okay, so now here table of 65 we don't know, so we need to prepare here table of 65. Let's do it. First write table of 5. 5 2s are 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 20, 25, 40, 30, 35, 40, 45, and 50. Then write table of 6. 6 2s are 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, 42, 48, 54, and 60. Now what you have to do? See, 6 and 5, 65, okay? See, what you have to do first? See here, in the table of 5, all the ones place digits you have to write here. The 0 will come here, then 5. So see, 5. This 5 we have written here. All the ones place digit of this table of 5. In this table of 5, we have to write here. Your 5, 0, 5, 0. And this tens place digit we have to carry in the next. So here see, 6 you have written, 12 plus 1, 13. 18 plus 1, 19. 24 plus 2, 26. 30 plus 2, 32. 36 plus 3, 39. 42 plus 3, 45. 48 plus 4, 52. 54 plus 4, 58. And 60 plus 5, 65. So here we have table of 65. Okay. Now let's divide 40,950 by 65. Now see this 40. It is less than 65, right? So directly we'll divide 3-digit number, 409. Now, is there 409 in the table of 65? No, there is no. Then the number which is less than 409 in the table of 65 is 390, correct? 390. So 1s are, 2s are, 3s are, 4s are, 5s are, 6s are. 65, 6 are, 390. Let's subtract 390 from 400. 9 minus 0, 9. 0 minus 9, not possible. So 10 and here 3. 10 minus 9, 1. 3 minus 3, 0. Take 5 down. So let's divide 195 by 65. Yes, there is 195 in the table of 65. 65, 3s are 195. 0, 0, 0. Here one more 0 remain. Let's take it down. And we need to divide it, this 0 by 65. 65 zeros are 0. Okay. So, the cost of, what is the answer? 630, right? So, cost of 65 benches, sorry, cost of each bench is rupees 630. That means what? If you multiply cost of each bench, that is 630 by 65, you will get total cost, so, rupees 40,950. Understood? So cost of each bench is 630. Let's move towards the next question. Question number 20. How many 50 rupee notes are required to make an amount of rupees 2,15,000? Okay, so the total amount is 2,15,000. So here they have given in the words. In words, we have to write in the numerals. So 2,15,000 means 2,15,000. Once tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, and lakh. 2,15,000. This is the numerical expression of this. And each note is of rupees 50. Each rupees 50. So to make 2,15,000, how many 50 rupees notes are required? What we'll do here, again we need to divide this total amount by each note, okay, value of each note. So 2,15,000 divided by 50, then whatever quotient we will get here in this division, that is that much of notes are required to become 2,15,000. Okay, so let's divide. Now see here, when there is zero in the dividend and in the divisor at the end, it's very easy cut that zero. For this one zero in the dividend will be cut. Now remain here 2,15,000 divided by 5. Okay, so let's divide it. Here first we'll divide 21. 5 fours are 21. Oh, sorry, 20. Then 1 minus 0, 1, 0. Let's take 5 down. 5 threes are 15. 0, 0. Let's take 0 down. 5 zeros are 0. Let's take another 0 down. 5 zeros are 0. Over. So, how many notes of 50 rupees 50 are required? 4,300. So 4,300 notes of rupees 50 are required to make an amount of rupees 2,15,000. Understood how we have solved this? Pause this video, write in your notebook. Let's move towards the next question. Problem number 21. In a problem on division, Alka took the divisor as 32 instead of 23. She got the quotient 1380. What was the true quotient? So see this problem. There was one problem of division in which the divisor was 32. Sorry, the divisor was 23. But instead of 23, by mistakenly Alka took 32. So when she took divisor 32, she got quotient 1380. Then what was the true quotient? If she would have taken, she would have taken 23 as a quotient, which 23 as a divisor, then what quotient she would have got? That we have to find. Now see, in this problem divisors are given. This is true correct divisor, this is wrong divisor. So when she took wrong divisor, what was the quotient at that time? It is given. And when if she would have taken correct divisor, then what would be the quotient? That we have to find. But in this case, they have not given the dividend which is required to required to divide, right? So dividend is not given. That means let's consider dividend Vx. So you know that in the process of division, there is dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder, right? So dividend means what? The number to which we divide. Divisor means what? The number by which we divide. Okay, so here the dividend we have considered x. Now see, she has taken the divisor 32. So when she divided dividend divided by divisor 32, so when she divided that dividend by 32, she got quotient. Quotient means answer 1380. And here remainder is not given. That means what? Remember will be, must be 0, right? So directly they have given quotient. So x divided by 32 is equal to 1380. Okay, so here with this equation we have to find value of x, dividend. Okay, this when we will find the value of x, this we will use in another divisor to find quotient. Okay, so x divided by 32 is equal to 1380. So you know the transposive rule we have learned before, that to find x, this divided by 32 we will bring here. And when divide by 32 will come on the opposite side of equal sign, it will change its sign. First, I am writing this number 1380. Divide by 32, when it will come on this right hand side, it will change its sign into multiply, right? So, multiply by 32. So, x is equal to 1380 multiply by 32. Let's multiply 1380 by 32. 2 zeros are 0, 2 8s are 16, 2 3s are 5, 6 and 1, 7, 2 1s are 2. Okay, then put here 0, 3 zeros are 0, 3 8s are 24, 2 will be carried. This is the 9 plus 2, 11, 4. Okay, so 0, 6, 11, 4 and 4, 44,160. This is the dividend. Now, using this dividend, we will find quotient in the using the this true divisor. So, 44,160 divided by 23 is equal to what? This we have to find. So let's divide 44,160 by 23. Now you know table of 23, you must know 23 ones are 23, 23 twos are 46, but here there is 44. So ones are 23. So 4 minus 3, 1, 4 minus 2, 2. Let's take one down. 23 nines are 207. 23 nines are 207. So here 11 minus 7, 4, 0, 0. Let's take 6 down. 23 twos are 46. Let's take 0 down. 23 zeros are 0. So we have got 1920. So 44,160 divided by 23 is equal to 1920. So this is our answer. That means what? If she would have taken this true quotient, sorry, true divisor 23, in that case she would have got the quotient 1920. Once again, I am repeating this. In a problem on division, Alka took the divisor as a 32 instead of 23. So she got the quotient 1380. That means what? Dividend is not given, so we have considered dividend x. So when Alka divided the dividend by 32, she got quotient 1380. So here with this expression, we found value of x, that is we found what was the dividend. So once we got dividend here 44,160, then we divided that dividend by 23, which is the true divisor, right? So when this dividend is divided by 23, we got quotient 1920. So this is our answer. Okay. So thank you for watching today's lecture. If you doubt, just ask me on WhatsApp.